Hello, Internet. I am Leko, and this is Star Wars Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast, the sequel to Mysteries of the Sith, which was the sequel to Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight, which was the sequel to Dark Forces, which I haven't played. I've played, but not on the channel yet. Still don't know if I'm going to or not, but yeah, I'm kind of going through these in the order that I played them, and I didn't play Dark Forces until I got it on Steam many years after it came out, after all the series was already out, so anyway. This is, I believe, the opening text. I did a test recording earlier and went through the opening scene, so I believe this is 8 years after the Return of the Jedi. So the, you know, everything happened in Dark Forces 2 and Jedi Knight and all that, Mysteries of the Sith. So Kyle is, he doesn't want to be a Jedi anymore because of the whole thing where he briefly turned to the dark side and almost killed Mara Jade. So he's gone back to being a mercenary smuggler type deal for the New Republic. And eventually, circumstances will force him to become a Jedi again, but we're going to play the first couple of missions in this game just like old times, with nothing but a briar pistol and a couple of items. And we'll be with Jan, his pilot friend, who did not appear in Mysteries of the Sith. So I'm going to go normal, definitely normal. Not playing on easy this time. Not accidentally playing on easy. So here we go. You got loading screens and everything. And that sweet copyrighted opening theme. Jedi Knight 2, Jedi Outcast. It is a time of relative peace in the galaxy. 8 years have passed since the Empire's defeat at the Battle of Endor, but the New Republic still struggles to restore order and vanquish its enemies. After defending the Valley of the Jedi from the evil Jarek and nearly falling to the dark side himself, former Jedi Knight Kyle Katarn has severed his connection with the Force and returned to his mercenary ways. With his longtime partner, Jan Ors, Kyle continues to aid the Republic in the fight against the Imperial Remnant. As the Remnant launches its latest gambit to regain control of the galaxy, Kyle and Jan have been sent by the New Republic to investigate the planet Kejim, once home to a long-dead Imperial outpost. And there's Kejim, and there's Kyle and Jan in the Raven's Claw, because, if you'll remember, the Moldy Crow got a little banged up in our last adventure.
Preparing for final approach. Whatever's causing those transmissions, it's not showing up on any of the sensors. This Imperial outpost looks as abandoned as reported.
It's as dead as the rest of Kejim. Mon Mothma must be getting paranoid. She never used to send pros like us out on blue milk runs like this.
Kyle, Jan, greetings.
Mon Mothma, Kyle was just talking about you.
No doubt. I bring troubling information about your mission on Kejim.
I hate it when you say troubling.
We've managed to decode a small fraction of the transmission we intercepted earlier, and, well, listen for yourselves.
I will fire.
The
Valley of the Jedi?
Reborn?
We believe this transmission was intended for Galak Fire, the suspected leader of the Remnant forces in that sector. It's probably nothing more than a couple of soldiers telling tales around the glow lamp. But as you are the only survivors of the Valley of the Jedi incident, I thought it only fair to warn you that this mission may be more dangerous than we originally anticipated. Your objectives, however, remain the same. Find out what you can, clear out any remnant forces you encounter, and may the Force be with you.
So much for the blue milk run.
Oh.
I think I saw someone.
Okay, we're just going right into it. No transition there from the cutscene. So, yeah. This game came out in 2002 or 3, I believe. It does not have very good character animation, as you probably saw. And it actually does not run in HD resolution. I had to download a couple of mods to get it to look as nice as it does. So, you know, keep that in mind whenever you see something that... when you see the particularly not amazing character animations, particularly the faces. But, yeah. You won't be looking at faces a lot except in cutscenes, so... yeah. So we have arrived at the Imperial base on Kejim, or the Remnant Imperial base. Oh, you never say that, Stormy. You don't ever say that. It was not a quiet last day. He was just about to transfer out of here. So yeah, we need to figure out what the Remnant is doing here. Because this base is supposed to be abandoned.
To deal with.
That's cold, Jan. That was a human being. Sorry, were you gonna say see some ID? Because this is my ID. It's a Briar pistol. You don't need to see my identification. Okay, I cannot aim, and I have a... seriously? This guy put up a hell of a fight not getting shot.
Blasters aren't going to do much good against that.
I'll see if I can find a way to get the door open. Wait here, Jan.
So, yeah. First couple of missions. Standard Star Wars first-person shooter. Just like in Jedi Knight, in Dark Forces 2. We're not getting the lightsaber until later.
The Remnant usually has pretty tight security. Make sure you search any officers for key cards.
That's a thing. Yeah, there's... it still has a lot in common with the earlier installments in the series. There will be health and shield pickups in addition to these boxes. The green ones give me shields, yellow ones give me ammo. But actually, and there are also secrets, but you don't get anything aside from, like, the items there. Like, it doesn't give you force upgrades or anything like it did in Dark Forces 2. But there is one such area over here. Actually, I don't think this one's even a secret. It's just here. But, yeah, I want... isn't that a shield? Why can't I pick that up? Oh no, that's a battery. So I still have my inventory full of items. I will make good use of Bacta tanks. There's no way I was close enough to that, but okay. And I have... oh, I don't have... oh, I do have the binoculars. Yeah, whoops. Oh, and I have, instead of a lightsaber, in case I ever run out of ammo instead of punching things, I have the stun baton. But I'm Kyle Katarn. I let my Briar pistol do the talking. So after that detour, we're just gonna figure out how to get inside this base, because the front door is pretty solidly locked. So if I go in here, take the elevator up, and actually I think I want the blaster rifle because it's got some good rapid fire. And never mind, this whole area is empty. But I want to power up that blaster turret.
Perimeter defenses online.
Did that do it?
No, but you managed to get everyone's attention.
So I did. It's fine, though. Oh, he did a flip. Style points for that guy. Yoink that back to tank. And there's nothing else here. Camera. Bunch of text that I don't feel like taking the time to translate. And I will probably not even bother doing that in editing because I really just don't care all that much. If you want to translate it yourself, just look up the Arabesh alphabet and go through the video frame by frame until you find a clear enough shot and post a comment telling me what you translate it to. But we're just gonna blow open the door.
That's one way to do it.
That is indeed one way to do it. And it's the only way because the controls have been blasted. We're just going down. And I'm gonna use that Bacta. I'm probably gonna be doing that a lot.
Stay here.
Oh, and actually, before I forget, there is quick saving. But I don't know. It's F12.
Cover our back.
Okay, I'll wait here. Don't take all day.
Well, no, I don't want to go back up. God damn it. I was trying to figure out what the... quick buttons. I mean, I guess I could quick load, because I quick saved while I was down there, but whatever. I go here. More importantly, I go wherever I want, because I am Kyle Bloody Katarn. Alright then. And because I am Kyle Bloody Katarn, I'm just an all-around badass. Even without a lightsaber and force powers and all that, I can do whatever I want. Quick save. Oh, side door. Oh, this is under the elevator. And there's nothing to do here. Ow. Okay, well. Okay. Oh, that was weird. Couldn't write config. Okay. That's probably because of the mod. The mod that I'm using to get this to run in higher resolution with slightly improved textures. So that's a lot more, cleaner than it would normally be. I forgot to do this. And, well, there... Okay. I was like, there should be a fireball somewhere. And... We're trying to get into the security station. Which I have just done. Now take that key, open all the doors, and now Jen can push some buttons herself.
I think this is a primary control console.
If you say so.
Got it. I think I'll hang out here a while and see what kind of trouble I can cause.
Sounds good to me, Jen, old buddy.
Spread out and find him.
Found me. I mean, I'm running around blasting everything in sight. I'm not exactly hard to find. If anything, spreading out made you a better target. Yeah, as much as I love the iconic Briar pistol, the Stormtrooper rifle really is surprisingly more accurate. So I think it's the helmets that cause the Stormtroopers to have their notoriously imprecise aim. And also when they have orders not to actually kill the main characters of the story. Oh, I got the light amplification goes. Hey, Gonk! Been a while. What's been up, my dude? Okay, I guess you're busy. Let's go up, or down this elevator. This is why we have the night vision goggles.
Kyle, the schematics show that the base is divided into three sections.
Aren't they always? Well, not always. They're always arbitrarily divided into random sections. Hey, Mouse Droid. Yeah, I just saw Gonk upstairs. I can still hear him gonking around up there. What are you doing down here? Don't you have some Stormtroopers to lead to their post or something? Yeah, okay. Boop! Oh, come on. Get dead. Thank you. Good lord. Okay, we're just gonna hit that, turn all those on.
Imperial code.
It appears to be a diamond with a blue thingy on the side. Yeah. And that is helpfully in my datapad, so I don't need to remember that. And those codes are not randomized. There are three of them. There's a red, green, and blue. So if you do remember them, you can get through this area significantly faster, and that is in fact a speedrunning technique. So if you know the code, you can just put it in and go straight to the next area without having to explore two-thirds of the base. Whoops, I'm going in circles. I do not intend to speedrun this. I mean, I'll get through it at a reasonable pace because because I know the game to a certain extent. But I'm not gonna break any records. And this is where we enter the codes. So the blue one. Oh, right. I have to turn a thing on. Those ceiling turrets are usually what kills me. Oh boy, I am not in good shape right now. Okay, we all clear. Do I have back to? Nope. Now I do, but more importantly, there's a shield charger here. That's a little more useful. Hey. Take that. No ID. Okay. Oh, come on. Sent that right over his head. That's a thing I need Jan for, but first I want to... Oops. Okay. I don't need to reload anything, so I'm gonna end up hitting R a lot, which scrolls through weapons. Whoop. Don't mind me. I'm just gonna turn that off. Yeah. That. Come on. Bring it on down. Going up. Thank you. Oh. I don't need to be here. I don't need to be in this elevator at all. Why does this elevator exist? All it does is take me back out to the starting area. Back to tank. Yes. Save that for a rainy day. Alright.
Jan, I'm gonna need your help. There's an access terminal here, but it's encoded.
I'm on my way.
Oh, actually. So Jan's gonna get attacked by a bunch of stormtroopers, and we have to go help her. And I think going out back through the front door is a faster way to get there. Come on, going up. Whoop. One more. There we are. I'm just gonna... Ow, okay, that wasn't good. Oh, I had three. Come on, Jan. Hold on. She's just in this front area. Oh my god, open the door. Not this one. Oh yeah, she's in this one. What, you couldn't handle three stormtroopers? Come on. I thought you were a badass like me. Okay. Now, where was that panel? It was...
What? Am I supposed to do this alone?
What are you talking about? Okay.
Hey, where are you going?
Huh. Never had that happen before. She calls you out for going the wrong way. Where'd you guys come from? Okay, they just kind of appeared behind us. That panel was in the green section. And it was through here. And it's right here. I always find the way.
This looks interesting. Piece of cake. That should get you where you need to go. I'm going to keep at this and see what I can find out.
Right on. Hi, we'll go through the door that just opened. That's not the... That's not it. And if these doors were, like, numbered or something, here we are. Nope, no one's here. Definitely no one here.
I found another code.
There's the green one. Those are glass and not hologram. Use that vector. Staying healthy. Okay, so I think that takes care of the green section. So I need to go to the red section and get the red code, and then I can... Oh, no. I thought I turned those off. but it's fine. Because even though I'm not a Jedi, I'm still fast as one. Because I am, in fact, the player character of a video game. Yeah. I do not have the aim of one, though, apparently. Just go up. Yes, it does. And this will turn on the thing that I need to put the code into. But I still don't have the red code, and I don't remember what it is, and I would rob you, the viewer, of some of the experience of this game. So I'm not gonna skip things, even if I did know how. Open up. Back to... Oh, I need a key. What's this button do?
We'll send the message immediately.
Okay. Let's see what we can intercept.
Convey my dissatisfaction with Commander Steven on his performance. Inform him that he's been removed from command and will be reassigned. That is all.
I wonder who that mysterious deep voice Imperial leader is. It's definitely not the main villain of this story, I'm sure, that we haven't even met yet. Probe droid transmission.
Please proceed with your transmission, Admiral Sayar.
So Admiral Fayar is indeed involved, like Mon Mothma said. Okay. Well, get the message to this guy. And quick save. Because as soon as I... Yep. As soon as I open the door, that's gonna explode. And... More importantly, this entire catwalk is gonna explode. And I do believe it will kill you if you are inside it when it does. Kind of a timer there. I'm not sure if it's if you trigger it by going through it or if it's on a timer.
What was that?
Just another day at work, Jan.
I vaguely recall getting caught on something and like dying in there when that happens, but I could also just be misremembering. Oh, hi. You guys look like you're having fun. Oh, jeez. I didn't even do anything. I was just waiting for the elevator to come back down. I think the probe droids are a little tougher in this one than they were in the other ones. But I also don't have the strongest guns right now, so that could also be part of it. I want to go up. Oh, really? Please die. Explode, please. Man. And there's another one. Oh. Good shot. Okay. Oh, can I please get back up on the... There we are. I wanted that shield booster. So I want to go along the top of this. And I can't... Because the bottom of this tube is like... partly exploded, so you can't go through it normally. Oh my god. You must find him, huh? I'm right here. What good did finding me do? those. Whoa, hello guys. How did none of that hit anybody? Oh boy. And quick save, because I could die here. I could definitely die here.
I found the last
code. There's the red code. Okay. And oh, please, guys, come on. Oh boy. Can you not? Could you seriously not? Okay. Well, I get to use this to recharge my blaster. Oh, hi. Please, don't sneak up on me like that. I will absolutely annihilate you. I desperately need health. Can I go up here and... Yeah, I can get out here. Okay. Oh! That could have been death. Okay, so the blue one is... What? I thought I turned it...
Offline.
I thought I turned it on! What did I... What was that button that I... Oh, I remember now. Okay. No, it was in the... Wait, was it in the red one? I can't even remember where I've been. Like, 3 minutes ago. Hopefully this doesn't kill me. Oh, no, wait, I turned him off. That's right. Around here. Yeah, it was in the red. Just gonna go up here. And, yeah, the button I hit turns off a force field around that button. And that button is the one that actually turns on the code thing. Boop. Yeah. And I don't know if I have the health to survive this fall. I do. Cool. Who's coming over? Uh-oh. Yeah, someone is here, but I really would like to not be shot at for, like, 2 minutes. Is he the only one? Nope. You. Oh, I got him. Okay, so the blue one. No, it's that. That. And... Wait, it's not that. Which one has the thing on the side? Is that it? No, it's on the other side. Which one has it on the right? Okay. There. That's blue. And the red one is kind of a derpy, like, smiley face devil. Which I guess is gonna be that. There. That's red. And green is just kind of a... Whoa. Okay. Didn't know I could do that. I can just hold tab and it'll cause the screen to freak out. Two triangles and a sort of... that one, and that one. Okay. And
Jan, prep the ship for takeoff. I just want to check out one last area.
Meet with the ship.
Cool. And with that, I have unlocked the next area of the base. Well, if I could avoid getting shot at long enough to get inside. Oh yeah, I forgot it gives you, like, stats and stuff. Okay. but it loads so fast that you don't really get a chance to take a look at it. So, with that, I think that's a good place to end the episode. So, next time we'll go through the rest of this base, figure out what the Imperial Remnant is doing here, and make them go away. See you then.